जी सर, कमिंग टू लेट्स गो बैक टू फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल क्लियर द बाइडन स्टेटमेंट एंड वी हैव बीन हियरिंग दिस सिंस लाइक 2001 व्हेन दे स्टार्टेड द वॉर ऑन टेरर. दे यूज द टर्म्स लाइक रोग एलिमेंट्स फॉर द इंटेलिजेंस एजेंसी एंड देन फॉर आर पाक आर्मी दे स्टार्टेड लाइक अ नेगेटिव नैरेटिव. समटाइम दे वर सेइंग दैट द तालिबान दे आर 100 किलोमीटर फ्रॉम इस्लामाबाद. पाकिस्तानी न्यूक्स आर they're gonna take over the nuke. Sometime they were saying that the terrorists are going to get hold of the nuke. But all these narratives, I think now when Biden is back as president, they are continuing from the same point right now. And Joe Biden right now, I mean, if you see that they were threatening Saudi Arabia yesterday on oil, and they like couple of days later he started threatening Pakistan on the nuclear arsenal. But this time there is a different thing that he's not saying it that it's a rogue element or the terrorist groups or the Taliban. He is taking the whole Pakistani nation in it, and he said that Pakistan is the most dangerous nation, like every one of us is like the most dangerous nation in the world. So what do you think? Why are Americans concerned about Pakistani preemptive strike? I mean, when they know that if Pakistani territorial integrity will be challenged, they will go for the preemptive strike. Do you think that they are sure on that? That is why they are countering it before the things happen?
Always remember the Indian strategy of attacking Pakistan. Before they launched the military invasion, like they did in 1971 into East Pakistan, Indians focused on two critical mission objectives, and they achieved them both before the invasion. Number one was to create enough political and military anarchy inside Pakistan so that Pakistan army gets bogged down inside the country, more involved in internal security duties than defending the borders. And secondly, Pakistan is isolated globally within the big powers, within the powers that matter. And India has forged an alliance with them against Pakistan. In 1971, India had forged an alliance with Soviet Union and Israel, and they had the tacit support of the Americans. Americans had actually allowed them to capture East Pakistan, and bluffing continued to bluff Pakistan. The Americans were Pakistani allies, that they continued to bluff Pakistan that we are sending the 7th Fleet to the Bay of Bengal to prevent the Indians from taking over East Pakistan. Complete bullshit, complete bluff. Entire Pakistani state and the leadership fell for these lies. And American Indians were comfortable. They knew that no 7th Fleet is going to come. And they had an open field, isolating Pakistan diplomatically, trapping Pakistan army in the internal security duties, and then invading the country from the outside. This is exactly what the Indians are doing now. They have forged alliance with Israel again, with the Americans. And as far as Pakistan's security is concerned, they know that Russia is not going to fight for Pakistan. China is not going to fight for Pakistan. Pakistan will have to fight on its own two feet, stand on its own legs, and defend its own honor, land, and territory and property. No other country is going to fight for Pakistan, especially if Pakistanis are not willing to fight themselves. So what the American Indians have done is, for the last 2 years, they were massively preparing for an invasion, conventional weapons, but just last week, they have finally tested their second strike capability from a nuclear submarine launching a nuclear missile. That is the culmination of their preparations required. And immediately after that, the Americans, Biden, first targeted the entire country, you are right. And secondly, they are targeting Pakistan Army specifically. You were very right, as you said previously, they were talking about militant groups taking over Pakistan. Now they're not talking about that because since 2001, they have been creating this propaganda that Pakistani state and its nuclear weapons are going to fall into the hands of the terrorists. The terrorists, which the Americans and CIA and Joint Special Operations Command, JSOC, was launching from Afghanistan themselves. And they were making Hollywood movies, giving the perception that Pakistani nukes are going to fall into the wrong hands and American Green Berets and Special Forces are moving in, entering into warehouses and picking up Pakistani nukes. That kind of bullshit. They were actually predictive programming. They were creating the perception globally that this is how they're going to do with Pakistan. They had CIA had an assessment that by 2015, Pakistani state will collapse. That is why they had removed Musharraf, because he was still holding the country together. They brought in democracy. They brought in Zardari and Nawaz, who on one hand economically destroyed the country. And on second hand, the Pakistan was literally sent to dogs. The entire Pakistan was suffering from terrorism, suicide bombings. And that was the internal security crisis, which was creating the global perception and diplomatic environment that Pakistani nukes are about to fall into the wrong hands. But Pakistan Army fought back. Pakistan Army held the line. We regrouped, reorganized, counterattacked, took Sawat, took tribal areas, defeated TTP, pushed them back to Afghanistan. Almost 90% terrorism was crushed in Pakistan. 10% remained because still Afghanistan was their base area and they could operate from there. So now the Americans cannot build this narrative that the Pakistani nukes are about to fall into the hands of TTP or BLA, because their major power has been crushed. So now they are targeting Pakistan Army itself. You can see that in Pakistan also within the country, a most venomous campaign against the armed forces is being launched nowadays. Every political party is against Pakistan Army right now. Political party and their followers. There's not a single political party in Pakistan which is supporting Pakistan Army in these times.
They actually have the same narrative which the Americans had in this since 2001. They're actually the same narrative.
One could argue and blame the lead policies of the Pakistan Army also. They have actually played into the hands of this information war and narrative building, and they have not been able to proactive in responding to this information war. But that's a separate debate. But the fact is, on one hand, they are the entire country within the political party, the narrative is strongly anti-army. And now, internationally, they are targeting Pakistan Army as a rogue force. They have presented a resolution in the US Congress that Pakistan Army should be declared a terrorist organization for committing genocide in East Pakistan in 1971. So that is another axis of attack. And you can see it's very determined and focused attack on the Pakistani armed forces. They cannot see the RSS terrorism in India. They are completely ignoring the RSS Hindutva Zionism and their plan of Muslim genocide. Every analyst and thinker in the world is saying that India is on the cusp of a Muslim genocide. The 250 million Muslims would face, unbelievable biblical slaughter in the coming weeks and months. Nobody's bothered about that. India is not the dangerous place for them, according to Mr. Biden. India is not a dangerous place for minorities or Christians or Dalits or other low-scheduled castes. But Pakistan is the most dangerous place because Israelis want Biden to say that. And Biden, you know that. The man is a wind talker. He talks in the air. He sees ghosts. He's a demented. He's a demented completely. What would I say? His dashboard is fried, I call it. He can't even think properly. So this man is not speaking for himself. It's the strong American Israeli Jewish lobby inside America that is controlling the US foreign policy now, using the American power and the Indian power to try to destroy the greatest threat the Jewish state feels for itself. That is an Islamic country with nuclear weapons. So at all cost, no matter what, even if they had to burn the entire Asia for it, Israelis cannot tolerate Pakistan having nuclear weapons. And they will use the American muscle and the Indian military to do this. And right now, when the whole world is already in turmoil and on the edge of a world war, this is the most ideal time for them to wage an invasion on Pakistan. And Pakistanis should be very, very concerned at this, because the political discourse and leadership quality in Pakistan and the economic crisis and the disharmony and disunity in the country right now is actually alarming. while our enemies are so single-mindedly, determinedly focused, like they were in East Pakistan in 71. It was not just a military diplomacy or military strategy that won them the war. First, they had won on the information war axis, on the psychological warfare axis, on the diplomatic axis, on isolating Pakistani state from the rest of the world. And only then they were able to achieve the battlefield victory. And right now, all other factors are in place. Only the invasion is remaining. Pakistan is economically challenged. We have very corrupt and poor leadership. We have internal fighting going on, literally on the verge of the civil unrest. And all these signs are dangerous, very, very dangerous. We need a serious course correction. Otherwise, the strategy of the Indians to invade Pakistan and get under our skin, get under our nuclear threshold, enter into our cities and fight an urban war where we cannot make use of the advantage of having our own nuclear weapons, is the possibility is very real. We need to be very, very concerned and very, very careful.